Hello children, today I'm going to summarize the lesson Deep Water from English textbook Flamingo of class 12. The author of this lesson is William Douglas. Deep Water is an excerpt from his book of Men and Mountains. Deep Water is an autobiographical account in which he discusses his close childhood connections with nature. He talks about his fear of water. He gives vivid description of his fear. He talks about the incident that almost killed him. He later talks about how he has strengthened himself and overcame the fear. His mother warned him against River Yakima. So YMCA swimming pool was safer because its depth was known and there was a gradual slope in it. This is how he assessed the pool to be safe. So there he was given the water wings so that he could remain on the surface. He talks about his lean and thin appearance, his skinny legs, but he subdued his pride and entered into the pool with his naked legs. This shows his love to learn swimming. There in the pool, Douglas remembers how he got the aversion. Now, when he was 3 or 4 years old, he went to California beach along with his father. There the waves knocked him down and he was submerged in the water. It was just because he didn't know how to hold breath. Father laughs just looking at his situation because he knows that it wasn't dangerous. The situation wasn't dangerous for his son. But Douglas, he developed a fear from water. He wanted to learn swimming, so he started going to the swimming pool. Whenever he was in water, he used to recollect the fear from his past experiences. As the time passed, he started feeling comfortable in the water whenever he was in the pool. And then one day this incident happened. He was all alone, sitting at the side of the pool. The water was still transparent and he was waiting for other children to come, as he was little scared to get inside alone. Meanwhile, another big boy, probably a teenager, arrived there. He pushed Douglas into the swimming pool just in fun. He threw him into the mid of the pool. Douglas landed into the pool in sitting position. Although he was frightened, his mind was working. His mind devised a plan. He planned out to reach to the bottom, make a big jump there, and come to the surface, lie flat, and then reach to the edge of the pool. But practically, that journey of 9 feet, the depth of the swimming pool was 9 feet. So that 9 feet journey appeared 90 feet for him. So it was very difficult. When he reached there, tried to make a jump, but it was not that big. When he reached to the surface, only his eyes came out. He suffocated. He swallowed more and more water, again started going down, choked. And he was overpowered by fear. Then he moved his arms desperately. He tried again. That is the third time. And then here he was somewhat paralyzed. He screamed. But the fear of death overpowered him. That seized all his efforts. Brain stopped working, The efforts stopped working. He experienced death. He was finally dying, about to die. The curtain of life fell for him as he became unconscious. When he regained his senses, he saw himself lying at the side of the pool and he was vomiting. And that boy who pushed him into the pool, he was standing there and was trying to explain that he did not mean to hurt Douglas. After this incident, Douglas feared water. He avoided going to the water sources. Horror grabbed his heart whenever he was in water. He became paralyzed in the situations when he used to be in water. He couldn't enjoy the water games, boating, etc. But he wanted to overcome the fear. His desire was so strong that he hired an instructor to train him. The instructor trained him step by step, and as a result, Douglas could swim now. But he wanted to make sure that he had fully overcome his fear. He chose different venues, went to different lakes. He swam there and he checked whether he has overcome the fear or not. And whenever he was alone, he could feel that the tiny vestiges of the tiny signs of fear could return. So he further went to Lake Wentworth, swam across Warm Lake, could overcome his fear finally. So this particular lesson indicates that his fear was baseless. It was embedded in his subconscious mind. So whenever he was near or in a water source, the fear would relapse. But when he himself firmly decided to overcome it, he could do it successfully. So the only thing to fear is fear itself. This is what the lesson teaches us. And this person, Douglas, could later live his life to its fullest just because he himself wanted, he strongly wanted to do that. So the first thing you're going to do is underline the new or the difficult words, find their meanings and write them down. Then develop a note making based on the lesson and maintain it neatly in copy, and write down all the question answers in the copy. The fourth thing is to write down the theme of the lesson. Here, as per instructed, the note making of the lesson, your own title, the headings in your own words, could write it down neatly, maintain the indent, neatness, everything, underlining, minimum 4 abbreviations, and complete your copy. Thank you.